Is this hand powerful? Enough. Okay, is this hand good enough? I think yes, because we can do bottom one Narcomia, then you have Horn plus Loam, which is perfectly fine. And Fetchlands to follow up. Giver of Runes. Not exactly what I wanted to see. Generally speaking, Dresh has a hard time with this card. Because we have only two conflagrates to deal with it. Okay, so we will probably play are playing against Hammer. And game one versus Hammer when we have Giver is kind of tricky. Butterskull, okay, so it's what is this to be honest? Okay, maybe they will attack and we can flip to Narcomoebas. Keeping Chili is not the best, but Forgotten Cave can help us in mid game. Maybe Dredger. Maybe not. Not the best situation. And of course Ludigi draw. Cost quarter? No. This castle is unusual. So it looks like taxes. Mirran Crusader looks like a problem. But we have blockers and we have conflag. Assuming if we flip our library quite fast, we can just kill Giver and kill Crusader. Okay, Stinky Dip is great here. Creeping Chill. Okay, now coming by school. But we can also Ox, but the biggest problem with Ox here is that we will discard a lot of cards and I want my first conflagrate to be quite big. So I think I will go to Loam and naturally discard cards. And now we can just try to block something. Not a bad situation. We don't have enough power to compete. Hey, do you want to represent blocks? Or do you want to attack? Probably attack is better. Then later we can jump with this Narcomoeba, this Crusader and do stuff. So now I can discard two cards. It's probably Imp and Bloody G. And if you flip Conflag, we can just deal a lot of damage with Conflag. Plus return Bloody G's. Sad the opponent has Butterskull. So this tempo plan won't be that good. Okay, so opponent is taking control route here. I found Conflag, which is cool. So the line Conflag plus Ox looks reasonable here. The real question is do we want to attack? Because we can attack with three creatures. If an opponent needs to block, they will use Stoneforge to play Butterskull. Then we go for big conflag. They will take care of something, but when we will kill most of opponent's board, so I think it's okay to attack. Okay, didn't expect this block. Okay, it was kind of obvious, to be honest. Okay, now we have two chills in the deck. So if we go all in conflag face plus ox and we flip two chills, we win. But you know, we need to flip two chills to do that. Although, what are the odds? Okay, Okay, on the other hand, we can go conflag, try to kill stuff, but we'll keep kill Giver, Giver will protect Miran. And the real problem is Batterskull with Miran Crusader. Shiva Seven Smoke. So I think it's okay to just try to win this turn. Assuming they have another land. Yeah, I know, but the problem is that if we attack with Miran Crusader, with Batterskull, we'll be very far behind, and also we can find more creatures to attack back, maybe. Also, we can just kill Giver and 5 to the op. 5 plus 2, this looks much better in my opinion. Because we still need to flip two chills to win. So if we go 2 plus 5, opponent at 6, so two chills will still be little. Let's try. Sure. It's always a 50%, you hit or you don't. But okay, to be honest, in reality, it's more about flipping more power. Like double chill is cool if you happen to have it. But if, for example, if you can flip two amalgams plus standard comibas to block, it's also good enough. Maybe not enough, but it's also reasonable. Wow, so much. I even broke Dread Chain. That's something, I have to say. Bloody Jihaste is not that good with Lifelinker. So, we would let opponent to block. Like, my idea was if opponent taps and blocks with Amalgam with Germ, then we can just kill a lot of other creatures. Okay, so there's a lifelinker here. A big one. Okay, I don't feel we have lines here to do stuff. And to be honest, we can just kill Crusader with Conflag and we should be fine. And the biggest problem here is that this stone fortress represents lit. Okay, can we just force opponent to block? Probably not. It's 5, 10, 15, 17. We are one short. So now we have a decision: do we want to maximize damage or to try to kill Stoneforge in blocks? Can go like this and then double block. If opponents use 5 mana to tap this, to equip this, it's probably good enough. Then opponent will go 5, 6. I think it's the best attack here. Okay, if we attack with this 5, 2, opponent will go down to 2. Then he'll go up to oh, maybe it's better to attack with everything. But Narkomiba. Opponent go down to 2 plus 5 to 7. Then we have a flyer attack, flank attacker plus Oxofagon. Okay, this is a good attack. So now we charm block and then we have exactly beetle with flying attacker plus 2 chills. If opponent has land plus path, sure. I have quick maths time. How to flip exactly 16 cards? We have 4 draws, so it can be 3 plus 3 plus 5 plus 5. Yes. If we attack with everything. Then this blocks this and negates these two, and we deal 5 more damage. Okay. Okay, chat, do you want to attack with everything? I think yes. Opponent wrote Vov. Don't get it, to be honest. Okay, we can also just return this. Attack, block, plus negate this. Okay, so my opponent is 1,000 IQ and still has this buff. So we can just play a land to return even more power. I'm supposed to cave first. No. Like, it doesn't matter, to be honest. Is there still? No, but we have a flying attacker and we can force through Butterskull. So we attack with everything. An opponent is dead. Yes. Fun game. Sadly, it was game one. An opponent will have some form of. No, I didn't have it. That's true. That's the biggest problem, auto side out. Two chills are quite easy, maybe another chill even. Dumping Matrix? Yes, that's why Secret Tech versus Helion decks. I'm testing this, and so far, so good. Also, Lightning Axe, what? A lot of cards to add. Something like this, maybe? Nethercat Aux is so powerful. Okay, we'll try like this. I don't know if siding out 3 chills is good enough. Generally speaking, I like siding out chills versus lifelink stuff. Okay, this is a reasonable hand. By reasonable, I mean I will lose to some cards, but I have lands, which is kind of important, versus tax decks. This poor. Oh. Do you think I'm not in my full power right now? Star Frosty. That was rude. What could go wrong? Yeah, there are some problems attached to this. Arbiter. So, using fetch lands in response is a cool idea. Suddenly we have two fetch lands in our hand. It can be a problem. Okay, and now we have some decisions. Do we want to reunion with two dredgers or dredge plus ox? Ja mam zaburzenia snu, Olaf, i teraz wychodzę z nich trochę. Było dobrze, później był Cyberpunk. I się znowu przestawiłem i teraz przestawiam się. Ja wstałem o 4:30 chyba. Ale poszedłem spać o 20, więc wiesz, przynajmniej śpię na raz 8 godzin, a nie śpię 3 godziny, 2 godziny, 2 godziny. To jest super. Polecam ten styl życia. Okej, so, probably reunion. I like discarding Ox, just like hope to not break on my first chain, and then I have escape. Maybe it's a bit too greedy. Yeah, that was greedy. Now I can safely say that. Also, I flipped another Ox, so well done. So the cool, well done. But it's not the worst case here. Ja miałem koszmar, że muszę iść do pracy z moim kierownik. Olaf, czy to było takie nieplanowane, wolne, takie prawdziwe? Oh God, quarter. So now there's a problem. Opponent decides to go for Mana Denial. Because we have lands, so for example trigger Blood Jace. But we won't be able to search for anything. To be honest about banning and unbanning dread stuff, I would love to see Breach from Below unban. Black Souls, interesting. Okay. So we need to top deck a land here. And then low and then blazon. Gracz. Well done. Not just being a magic card, yeah, like this design is kind of unique, if you ask me. Cabal Therapy, please don't. Dredge would be instantly banned. I probably want to make land drops and maybe pay one day for this arbiter. I also don't want to return Bloody G's, so I can wait with my horn. In my opinion, unbanned looting would be the best for the format. Oh, Field of Ruin, well done. So I think we will, like, unless we top deck like Guts, we'll be out of this game. Crusader opponent decides to throw this game if we top deck a land. Like, why not just ruin my game? Maybe they are scared of losing their own lands too, but they could also attack. Mardu Pyro is a meme. The memest of the memes. I think returning chicken to the format would be great here. Okay, let's try to draw a land, please. Fuck, that's a land. Next time I have to ask for Phoenix was like with Ura around and Scorch of the Skycliffs and other powerful stuff, chicken wouldn't be a problem. I don't have an idea what to do. Can try to return Amalgam, so I think we can flip. Gamson. Now I don't want to return Bloody G. No reason. Because it's blocked by two creatures. Okay, maybe opponent won't use Field of Ruin even this time. Who knows? Pantheon wasn't punished, yeah, like another day on MTGO. Okay, maybe this time, maybe opponent will be. Playing around the win. I'm out of records, no. Now we can consider jumping. I kind of like this. Just to maybe get another turn. We don't want to lose their land. True, but I would be on zero lands ever. Maybe they are just scared of my dread chain without lands, but it, like, this natural dread chain won't win versus Auriok anytime soon. Okay, I think I want to draw land like a pro, like non-fetch land. Okay, I will concede this because this is miserable. Never lucky. Yeah, we were play draw dependent to win this game. There could be my moment. Yeah, this should be my emote. I have like 4 or 5 slots for emotes. I created 3 of them. Okay, we are on the play, so Rune is probably a bit better. The rest is fine. That's a problem because I really like merchants in this, like the versus Talia and Lanyard Beater, but I don't have slots. Other cards are better. Maybe I should side up 3 Unions. Well, sadly. It's a cool hand. Keep bottom Amalgam, I guess. Think I will draw with Forgotten Cave and then loam it. Also, there's an upside to draw into Giver. Vial is even worse than Giver, but we can. Oh, right on time. So now we can go for loam, but it's super sad. I think it's better to Horn. The big question, do you want to represent Axe? I think yes. My life won't matter that much. So if opponent has Rip, we are dead. Oh, Talia won't be the end of the world because of Lightning Axe. Okay, this will be super fun because it will reset our Shikon. Okay, got me. I think I want to Axe, even if it's not the best creature ever to kill, but I just want to flip some lands for loam. What? Even more counters? Is this possible? Value. That's true. That's a definition of value. Amalgam, sure. Oh, okay, so we have some stuff going on. Okay, so we are out of Mana Denial Plan. Cosmic Brain Deal. Player. I want to use this first hand now to not be scared of. Arbiter, and I think I want to Forgotten Cave. Opponent would play Rip if they have it, so I just want to secure myself from top deck Rip. Oh. You will say it was luck, but I would say it's skill. Yeah, allowing Rennic Warden. Maybe that was a preparation for Rip. Who knows? That is a big skill deck. That's a rip. We are still fucked. Like, really hard. Thanks for the follow. Okay, how many response? We have two res. Sure. Two responses still. Like, also, I could return. Sorry, I could search for Blood Crypt to be able to cast Bloody G. Maybe this can punish me a bit. Nice first round. What we can do? Not that much, to be honest. You can concede and move too much too, please. Please don't. I have still one claim and one other decay. And plus zone if I'm very ambitious. So we have some outs. Like sadly, like with one more amalgam maybe we could be able to do some trash wars. Also not having this blood crypt can be a pain. Okay. Violent 3 looks hard to beat. I like playing versus Kate, like this is an interesting match to play. Playing versus Rip is low, great card. Probably want to just deal damage. Opponent can go for a lot of freeze, but whatever. The real question is, do I want to keep Imp in the blocking duty? The opponent will attack anyway. I'm losing that race, that's true. On the other hand, we are one top deck away from maybe flipping dredgers into creeping. Oh, sadly, I flipped the only one. I won game one, you know. I lost game two because of mana denial. And game three is like Vaidru Rip Apparition, sure. That was sad. I think like this was a reasonable experience post sideboard, but this game too, when I just like I drew just like I didn't have any control if I draw fetch lands or not non-fetchables. Perfect. But I think like the game two was easily winnable if we had regular lands, not fetch lands. But an opponent li really gave us some chances to top deck out of the situation. But you know, magic happens. Reasonable. What? That's reasonable. I think I want to long here just to prepare double spelling. Or maybe now we want maybe to re response to return amalgams. Okay. Let's try. Okay, we have Ox ready for next turn. Okay, interesting take is do we want to play a land here or not? Because if our plan is to Ox anyway, it's maybe better to try to flip Blood Gene top 3. How many games have you activated Majors of the Wasteland effect? Not that many, but it's something you can do. For example, in like versus taxes versus these slower decks. Siema Smilek. Found. Input is good. Can we attack first? Like the biggest problem will be probably Remand if it's a blue-green Titan variant. But we can play around and sit and wait. Maybe that's just Valakut. Tak. Okay, maybe not Kumba. Maybe not. Okay, but this is a reasonable setup for next turn. Because we'll be able to return some bloody G's. We also have Forgotten Cave. Yeah, this is a straight Red King Valakut, so it's. It should be our good matchup. Maybe not good matchup, but we should be faster than them. Okay, so I think the line here is to go for Loam plus Forgotten Cave later. That is nice. Good taste of the cool Hello Fina Loop. Zgoro's Bend isn't banned yet. is it banned? That's a real question. Okay, we can try to flip two chills and win. So in response to bloody G triggers, we'll try to flip. We can flip zero. And the question is now, do we want to play around? Because we attack for 6, so next turn Bloody Gis will be hasty. We will return 3 amalgams. So maybe we can afford to not return Bloody Gis at all. Agar plus my deck box. Like, luckily for us, regular Valakut decks aren't playing Bojukabok. At least they shouldn't. And even if they go Bojukabok now, it's okay. Like, the combination of cards can be a problem. That's just Mardu Pyromancer. Like, in modern, Dracos. I was playing Afterox, like, I had an red-green Valakut episode when I was scared of Gravehate before Grand Prix Prague, and I decided to play red-green Valakut instead. And I tried, and I had like 65% win rate on model, which is reasonable, and then I went for a Grand Prix, and I went 0-4. And I won only one small game when I was already 0-3. So it was a miserable experience to do. Okay, what do we want here? Blood Moon looks reasonable. They also can have a relic or cage. Maybe we can afford to have Blast Zone. Okay, we can say that one Blood Teaching. Maybe a Conflag. One Merchant, one Land. I don't know if it's correct. Looks okay. I don't understand why you're playing Scape Chip or Dryad Piles. The reason can be that you like your deck does stuff when you go for Trash Wars, but Field of the Dead does the same. So like I don't see any reason to play Red Green Valakut nowadays. What's the matrix for? Matrix is to stop Heliot. Because Because the problem with versus Heliotex is that you need to stop both Spike Feeder and both Spike Feeder and Walking Ballista. You can't name with Beating Needle both of them. Also Scavenging Ghost is a problem. Like there are a lot of different problems. And being for 3 mana means that if you go for Blast Zone for 2 with Fury of Champions on board, you won't destroy your Dumping Matrix. Why it's not Narcomoeba? Okay. We can just return 5 power. I think it's good enough. Like, in this type of matchups, you absolutely need to put early power on the board. Okay, another Union looks reasonable. I'll return it now because if opponent wants to anger my two creatures and not ramp, it's really good for me. Because now opponent can just go ramp into Titan and we should be losing this one. So I actively want my opponent to anger. Sadly, I went for Farsik. Elobeczek co tam? Magi tu uwa gościu, sobie streamuję. Znowu śpię jak człowiek i się z tym tak cieszę, jestem tak zajarany. Okay, what? Simian Spirit Guide into Sakura? Is this real? Okay, we found Golgari tak, which is nice. Okay, we saw Blood Moon. What we can do? Not that much, to be honest. Technique, we can flip 3 chills into more Bloody G's. There's no reason not to try. Here's the first one. And the second one, close enough. Okay, we have some things to do. Suddenly we broke our Dread Chain, but another Reunion in hand should help. One chill left. Now we return some Alagams, which is fine. I'm not dead because I have 29 life, so easy. We won't return this Bloody G because if opponent goes for example, Sweltering Suns or Primeval Titan into Valakut killing Amalgams, you can return it to represent more damage. Isn't it better not putting the Narco? Maybe. On the other hand, maybe that was a line here and just rely on Bloodgust. The problem is that if you need to Bloodgust to trigger, you lose 7 power, right? You have only 6. Yeah, maybe that was better. Like, first thing is that you can tell I'm going to UT. Yeah, that's why I'm keeping this Bloodgust in my graveyard. My reasoning here is that if opponent... Like, we are kind of forcing opponent to go for Anger now. Okay. Maybe a bigger contest of this. We don't know exactly what type of hate opponent can have. They can have Anger, so going to the board is quite bad. They can have Relic, so going on the board would be really good. They can just go for Primeval Titan, but we have Bloodgust with first chance, so going on the board is okay. They can just try to combo kill us with Furwear Bridge, sure. Okay, so I think we can be dead. Anyway. So about playing around different things, it's okay. It's 12 plus 6. It's only 20 damage, only lol. Okay. Okay, I'm not very good at maths. Okay, so it's 18 only. And I'll call you by super dad here. Sure. Okay, so I will just try to kill our amalgams blocks. That's a really nice line. Okay, so now we have some quick maths time. One, two, three mountains. So we have three mountains left. So we can go Reunion, try to find. Okay, we go down to eight. So we need to flip two bloody G's or one chill. Or top deck a land with conflag or top deck conflag. So I probably don't want to use this first hand, yes? We also have long. Long won't matter because we need to flip more stuff. So if we return this, they go for mountain to kill two amalgams and they take seven. Not enough. So we need to flip another bloody G to win. Gas in second main, what? Like what? Okay. So we have three mountains left in the deck. We need to flip. Okay, found chill. It's already good enough. Now we can try to find bloody G's if they have more removal. We still have three mountains in the deck. So odds to flip all three of them is quite low. Hello, Warim, 6-7. Okay, if I go mountain plus bolt, even having this another bloody G won't help. They go to eight, they kill these two. We go to five. So this bloody G won't matter, I guess. They had not paid attention to the last 10 sets they got released. Yeah, I feel like opponent just decided to play a league. Like, maybe opponent is playing only one league per year, right after Christmas. It's a magical time between Christmas and New Year's Eve. And they just return every year to play this one league with his their sorry their favorite deck. Red green Christmas colors chat. That's a good question. fan red green tech scales. Are scales red? I don't think so. Mulligan. Keep. Ah, that's super sad because we have two imps in hand and we want to bottom chill. Maybe it's a mulligan. Maybe not, maybe it's a game one, so we don't need shenanigans most often. So we can keep, and I think I want to bottom imp just to increase chances to flip them. Like having three dredges already in hand means that my horn will be just close to your stream to play some magic. That's fun. I can show you even chat. That's super funny. Extremely funny. Fling spell land? Do you have something like this? What? Oh no. Two lands, perfect. Dredger? No dredger. I bottomed one. Mull this shit. Yeah, maybe. Maybe you were right. Who knows? Also, maybe I returned one, not too many. Because now oxing will be harder. Okay. Spirits. Sure. Wanderer. At this stage, Wanderer isn't that powerful. Okay. Now we can not. Yeah, I think I returned one too many lands because now we lose another ox. Now we can refuse to use this chill, then crack fetch land, go for ox, and hope it's good enough. And I think it's a nice plan. Yeah, that's a big difference to flip to exile ox or not exile ox. Change the record. I can do that. Always forget to do that. Okay, sure. Okay, let's flip stuff. Okay, another ox, so at least this is secured. And I would love to flip anything else. Which is relevant. Okay, at least we have a 5-3. Rattle chains, sure. And now playing against spirits is a nightmare because we never know what they can have. Never. Attack. Opponent is very aggressive. Like, I think that this card would be better for 2 mana, like, not only 5-3, but 5-3 with some 3-3s around. Narcomipa is not really good in this matchup. So I think we need to attack and maybe force some action on opponent. We can go for just for another ox. Another ox is quite safe because it won't be countered by most of other stuff. Spellqueller, Wand Counter, Ox. Conflagrate is not safe because of Wanderer. I can go for another spirit plus counter. It's probably bad. The safest line here is to go for Rocks. Maybe this time we'll. Okay, we'll see if this resolves or not. Okay, resolved, sure. So now we need to flip Narco plus Amalgams. Okay, we found an Amalgams, which is cool. Found Narco, okay, this is a good flip. Yeah, the power of Ox. So we also have some 20-20 cards. People kind of forgot that Dredge also is a 20-20 deck. What? Wyvern over Magus. I thought Magus was considered better. The main difference is that if opponents wills to. Okay, we'll see if opponent is super lucky or only a bit. The spirit is. Oh, okay. That was a really bad Coco. Lightning Bolt is the biggest difference, for example, maybe not in a 4C, but versus Temururo. Or for example, versus Blue Red Kiki-Jiki. They have bolts, and you don't want to kill it. Other cards, like for example, Reclamation Sage Amulet happens, but you know, if they want to prepare, they will be able to deal with your card. And but for example, four color, they can just keep some buffs post sideboard, and if you go for Magus, they can just take mana to the mana pool and exile it. So it's easier to adapt to Magus of the Moon. Blood Moon is harder for them to deal with. Okay, we have some cards. Okay, we go for long, I guess. Oh, nice. It's a really good flip. We attack with all. They need to block three creatures. So all I want to do is to force them to do some jumps. Maybe not jumps because of selfless, obviously. Okay. Drog Skull Captain. No. So now we can technically go for Ox. Okay, how many lords opponent needs to play to kill us next turn? If one, three, plus four, seven, plus 11, not enough. So we need to play two lords. I think about playing Conflag here because it will force opponent to suck this. And also we have one chill left in the deck with Ritter some Amalgam, so it looks quite reasonable. Can just oh that's a nice line. That's a nice line. I wasn't thinking about that. Playing Stinkweed Pass. And we should win longer game, yes. Yeah, we have one chill left in the deck. Yeah, I like this line. It's really cool. Probably safer to go for loan. Okay, so the last card is chill. So now we can go for. Okay, we can attack with all. So opponent needs to. Need to have another blocker. We have only two cards. Coco into double deputy. Yeah, maybe. Okay, you know chat, YOLO. I won't think about this for that long. I'm not here to do combat math. Oh, my homie's headcock. Serious commitment here. Okay, so now this attack can lose me a game. Are you talking about blue-black Narset? Okay, point at two. Try to kill something. Never lucky. Okay, we go for conflict now. To force them to sacrifice. Sacrifice Wanderer? Sure. Just to decrease chances to lose. Quad Narset Pyre. Ah, this is a really good deck. Okay. Fuck me. I was 100% sure that I have another Creeping Chill in the deck. Fuck! And now I will lose this game. I'm so bad. What was this, chat? What was this? Why am I playing this game? Okay, maybe they will let me resolve this. Do not expect it will happen. Who knows? Qual spoiler? Fuck me. What I just did? I'm not sure, to be honest. I played this really bad. Even without this 100% throw with Dredge Free when I didn't have to, I shouldn't attack with all creatures, and like there were so many mistakes involved there. I should just slow Dredge and just play low again, again, and again. Okay, I will trade with Wanderer, with my loan. Resolved? What? What happened here? No idea, to be honest. Okay, maybe opponent just wants to protect. Rest in peace. That's not the worst. We have material to use conflag to deal with that. They even let me return low. This shouldn't happen. So we go for fetch land. Thanks for the follow. And 1-1 here. Like this. Maybe I shouldn't play fashion here, because I'm forced to use it anyway. Nine life already. That was a bit aggressive, if you ask me. What? Apparition, sure. Like what? Okay, I found a treasure, which is big. What happened here? Sadly, we don't have any land to return Bloody G right away. But that's reasonable. Because now we go for Conflag, Flashback, even like this, YOLO. I want to keep Loam in hand, the rest can go. But I show that they don't have. They don't have a rip, at least not now. The brown paper about the previous situation, this wasn't that easy. Because, like, they had a lot of flying power, so they could kill me. Like, maybe I could just play Stingray teams to be able to block and then one shot with Bloody G's. Probably want to attack first, even if it's not lethal. It will be one day, and I'm forcing maybe to spell Queller into block. Sure. We still have some Bloody G's to return later. But our Bloody G's hasty. How many? We have two mountains still. It's probably okay to wait. With this fetch land. Although we can just play fetch land, then go for Ox into Loam. Which is also fine. Siema mi o końcu nieporządnego dredgera, z definiu porządny. Max time, 1, 2, 3, 7, 8, 9 cards, so I think it's safe to. Go for this, sure. One, two, three, four, five, six. So Loam or another ox? That's the question. We exit one. No, but I don't think we need another ox because we want to flip cards and find another Bloody G event and finish this. How about not having it? Okay, now we can go for. Attack to deal 1 damage, but lose my board. Siema duo. Okay, we can just attack with Bloody G. They need to block and we will return Amalgam. A tak odnośnie kosmicznych rzeczy, to udało mi się, mając 3 karty w bibliotece, zdredżować Loama i nie znaleźć Creeping Chilla, bo już znalazłem wszystkie 4. Więc wiesz, dużo jest do odkrycia tutaj jeszcze. Tak, teraz już tak, bo jednego wysejdowałem. Może niepotrzebnie w sumie. Ok, we somehow won this game. And game 3 will be on the draw. I'm not a fan of reunions on the draw. Maybe we can go like this. Also, Ox is really powerful here. I don't like Narcomoeba, to be honest. It's a charm blocker most of the time. Yeah, typical slow hand, but reasonable. Kept. You keep two. You have Horn plus Loam with Forgotten Cave as a kicker. No, spirit, a co innego? Okay. Apparition. This is annoying. Maybe we can flip Dredger here. Okay. Nice apparition. Okay, this looks bad now. Because we don't represent anything meaningful. At least we have land drops and Ox eventually will be casted. That's too fast, that looks like rip. Well played. Okay, so opponent has screw. So we have two lines here. We can go for imp. Okay, quick check for black sources. We can go for imp, but we will let opponent play something for 3 mana next turn. And this can be a problem because we have flying forces. We can also try to draw into claim or decay with Forgotten Cave. And then go for Tapland and go with and Axe Noble Hierarch. I like it more, to be honest. Nice fetch land. Is MTG bot here? Should be. Okay, so they have some free drops. Ready. Maybe rattle chains too. Conflag is good here too. No attacks. Sure. This like a draft. This is worse than a draft. Any draft deck would be able to finish me. Okay, now the biggest problem is. You know about only problems here. Okay. End of dreams. Guess maybe we can throw into axe to kill blocker. Okay, can we afford to play around anything? Probably not. So we'll attack. Spellqueller incoming. What? I want to cast this horn. Probably. Like, it looks like opponent has a lot of quellers. What? That's nice. Okay, przed maximize damage. Witam z OZI 99. Miło Cię widzieć. Okay, you know, chat, YOLO. Attack here. Opponent's violon 2 is scary, but. Sure. Now the real question is, do you want to ox? Because like we can conflict for two, to for example kill Queller. Okay, so Selfless Spirit can be a problem, another Lord to protect Queller can be a problem. We can go just to face. And next turn Ox to draw into something, maybe it's better. Op at 4. Somehow. Okay, so Coco is unlocked. So I'm forcing a trade with Imp. Nie, bo musi się zegzajlować z grobu, więc jeśli masz go już na egzajlu, to on się nie ma jak zegzajlować. Okej, okay, now it's an ox time. Just draw three fresh cards. No, the definition of being good. You know, yikes is this. Not my draw, like, this game is over, like, for 3 turns already, but we are trying to improvise. Yeah, we lost all, like, we are 1-2 in a second, we lost 2 games, like, against white decks in exactly the same situation. We lost one game randomly, we won second game quite easily, and we are losing third one to Rest in Peace. That's life. Gonna go with Upsem. Usef, pierdol zebra od razu. Ok, 1-2. Perfect, perfect. The saddest part of this is that we are losing games when our decision does not matter that much. Like, opponent had rip. Well done. You played really well. GG's. If you say that rest in peace, slam is GG, that maybe we are playing two different games. Or maybe you are slamming and I'm losing to this slam. Okay, this is reasonable. Basically never beat spirits as dredge. Like, the only problem is this, like, game one with chills and ox is quite easy to beat. Like, I threw game one very hard. Like, this shouldn't happen. I should just stop attack at one moment. Ooh, two on variant, sure. Okay, another reunion means that we can be little bit more greedy with the first one instead of just going long. We can just try to flip cards. I'm using first shot now instead of Gorge because, oh fuck, because I want to increase chances to keep the red chain, so every card in my library matters. Sure. Oh, that's so sad. Troniarzem, to jest takie, no, brawo, Matronia. Świetnie zagrał. Okay, we have a land, so let's try to high roll one more time. What the fuck? Okay, so we had only one dredge card in top 20. Sure. Why not? So I don't have enough power to overcome any of payoff. Sorry, Drunken Present. Piegonti, hello. I subbed, but it didn't join. You subbed me? What? No, we didn't. At least I don't see that. Hello, Karn. So Karn into cage, I guess. The good thing that is that we can kill Dronhammer Sodek. Is this? Okay, this is a cage. Cage is really powerful, but on the other hand, we have tools to do something still. Because we can go for loam. So the most important question here is what else opponent has. I have 6 cards, so probably something. It's a blue tron. What? What? Okay, now it's significantly easier to play. We can just attack. We are probably paying one. You know, chat, it's not the end of the world still. Can just play our creatures and Blutron can't compete with returning to power on the board. Okay, we need to discard something. We have amalgams to cast on Arcomoeba, looks kind of bad. Probably one dredger, or maybe not. Or just 2 fetch lands. Maybe that was bad. So flipping chill would be really good here. Oh. More counter magic ready. Or flipping literally nothing is also fine. Oh, I made a mistake. I should go for loam Forgotten Cave now just to try to flip chill. Like, it's very lucky that we have some sort of counter. Okay, 6 mana. Okay, I can't win against 4/4 flying blocker. Fuck you, small card, I hate you. Okay, blue tron. Grudge sounds fine. Maybe like one claim. Kind of one flag, cut. Maybe one ox. I like blazon too. And one, what? Maybe one merchant. Blood Moon? Please don't. If you are losing to Karn into Gravehate, siding in Blood Moon is a mistake. Because they can just go to 4 lands regularly. You are losing tempo. And like your turn 3 should be a turn when you put power on board in this matchup. Most like turn 2 plus turn 3. And if you go for turn 3 Blood Moon, you are not putting power on board, then they still can go for Karn into Tormund script or Cage. You are still fucked. Nice one under. With looting this would be a keep, but they don't let me play looting. Well, this won't be a very long stream. Not the best draw, but at least it's a good four. Really? Like for real? Bro, of course broken red chain, because why not? At least top decking a land would be really good here. Yeah, my whole stream is big F. I feel that casting imp is reasonable here. This imp can deal more than one damage, because like every dredger I play is a possible one damage from conflagrate, so I kind of count them as a good card to cast if maybe they can block if it is important, or if I can deal more than one damage. And another, I'm not that tilted. You know, like I'm playing just a random nick. I was tilted when I owed to my championship with Belcher. I was super tilted. I went to Żabka, oh nice. Open remand or contestant me. Okay, is there any reason to wait this reunion? Probably not, because even if they counter, I can aux next turn anyway, and I have board presence. Żabka and I bought some beers to make sure that I won't be tilted anymore. Oh, perfect, perfect tap to not let my Ancient Grudge to be a thing. Wasn't the best plan, to be honest. Wasn't. Okay, first on knowledge, I guess. Okay, sure. Nie, no, wkurwiony byłem straszliwie, co tu dużo gadać. Najgorsze jest to w tym, że jakby, no testowałem do tego eventu i Belcher wydawał się dobrym strzałem. No i to, ba, no ziomek, z którym testowałem, zrobił top 4 właśnie pelką. I sideblock mieliśmy fajny, wszystko było spoko. Okej, no. Okay, maybe this stream will last a bit longer. No właśnie, wiesz, tutaj się szykowałem, o, będzie dużo euro, było dużo euro. Będą jakieś bear midrange były. Będą jakieś haliodziki. No tego nie widzieliśmy akurat. No ja dostałem taksy, gdzie widzieliśmy, że będzie dwóch graczy na 30, co grają taksami. I storma, gdzie widzieliśmy, gdzie będzie dwóch graczy na 30 stormowych. No i to właśnie to było to, że to poświęcamy. I jak siądzie, to siądzie. No i ja sobie tak poświęciłem, że poświęcamy. Starłem to coin flip i wiesz, przegrałem rzut kostką. No i starczyło. Także no trochę tilcik, bo by wygrywanie challenge to jest nic nie warta rzecz. Chciałem wygrać coś porządnego w końcu. Szanuję. Okej. This does not look like a keep, so we go down to 5. Go down to 4 again. Oh, maybe to 3, because why not? Okay, it's a really good 3. If you ask me. This, the best 3 you can ask for, always, all the time. Not the best draw ever. Like, sadly, Blunt Gas would be the best card to flip here. Just to set early power. Opponent has drawn. Fiddle. Okay, that's something. Okay. Sure. Nice three. Not first blood script. No, you want to have loam ready. And I started with a not fetch land because, like, imagine if I not flip fetch land but I flip other dredgers, then I can play a land, and then I can dredge more cards and still have one land drop ready to have more strategies. So, in this low resource fight, you need to prioritize as many land drops as you can. Prioritize to have as many land drops. It's a question. What do you want to do? We have two grudges in the deck, so it's not the end of the world. I probably go for loam no matter what, because I need to be able to double spell in mid game if I really want to win. Okay, we found grudge. Nice. Ugin, Orbalista. Sure. I can't say I have a really good flip, but doesn't matter to be honest. Okay, so now I can attack with everything and try to conflag my back to this game. Probably to play here. We can also go for Imp to not let them attack. Okay, I attack with everyone. If they block, I can conflag. Just try to brute force through this. Probably the best thing I can present here. The problem with Conflag Ox is that opponent has 3 Nisphere, so I can only play one spell. Okay, so opponent decides to. To trade here. Okay, so our amalgams can just now trade with worms, which is nice. Now, my hope is that opponent has blue spells and without islands. Oh, they have island. Because now every counter will be very hard to beat because like we can play technically one spell per turn. Maybe we can go for Loam and just set up double spell for later. Not a good leak. At least we can play some challenging games. So he has two lines here. We can go for Imp to block lifelinkers. Or we can go for Loam and try to double spell next turn. I like Loam more here. Which is nice. We can also Ox. Oxing isn't the worst, to be honest, but the risk of counter is really big. So we can attack with all but one amalgam. Just start trading with these lifelink tokens, something like this. So now we can block and return this amalgam later. Let's try to return. Okay, how many fetches do I have left? 1, 2, 3, 4, 2. One left later. I think the odds that I will have this fetchables later aren't very high. Okay, this resolved. This is strange. Okay, so I won't return this. No attacks. Do I want to attack with Bloody G's? I probably set it out for my Conflag, yes, so don't see any big reason. It's probably better to keep my Bloody G in the graveyard. The real question is, do I want to use Fetchland now? Probably is. Maybe cracking this fetchland is a mistake, but the odds to flip mountains aren't zero. Okay, I don't return this. Okay, another chill, more bloody cheese, which is nice. Okay, now we attack with. These creatures. Okay, with all four chills, so we have only combat damage to fight with. Okay, opponent can have Ugin, Karn. The real question is, I want to return these blood gusts. Because what? Okay, do we have a way to win if I go Ugin and minus? They can attack, for example, with one creature, go up to 5. If they don't attack at all, then we can garage one, they can block with a second one. We never win against Ugin. So against all other things, it's better to... Okay, maybe Cyclonic Rift is a problem too. This can be. Okay, we'll start with Imp. Imp is a little next turn. We don't do anything. So now I will just go for Ox. I probably won't return Vladigis, they don't mean that much anymore. Okay, we have Grudge next turn. So we should secure our win next turn with land drop plus Grudge. Probably want to trade with these tokens. Because of Cyclonic Rift. Fuck. Now not returning this blood gas hurts me. Okay, also it's also kind of interesting what they want to return. Fuck, maybe I messed up. Maybe I should, for example, at least return 2 to have 1 to trigger stuff. Yeah, because now I don't have literally they go for cage. Oh, I messed up this game. Yeah, Dredge is a type of a deck when it's close to impossible to play perfectly, colleague, because you have so many micro decisions against what you want to play around. Ballista. Sure. A ballista can be a problem. Not that much to be honest, because we can go for Ashen Grudge dealing with ballista, then we go for land. So we can kill, for example, Amalgam Narco. So in response we go for Grudge. Do you never auto yield? I clicked 5 to reset my auto yield because I was thinking a bit that I clicked F6 automatically. I auto yield a lot, but I auto yield amalgams and some other cards, but every May trigger I decide to not auto yield this because you know there are some corner cases when you don't want to return. For example, you don't want to return Narcomoeba, you don't want to use chill, and I want to don't want to create a memory muscle when it's an auto that it always resolves because, for example, like returning this bloody geese, it's not always okay. It's okay. Point can block here is exactly lethal. But I should return to the receiver. At least some of them. Okay, that was a nice game. 2-2, Free to Dream is still live for me. To some World 2-3 territory, like last game. I would love to keep more than 4 cards. Okay, keep. And again, the best 3 card ever. Okay. It's probably not Time Spiral Curtain, but I know what is it. It is a fucking joke that I need to mulligan all the time. Okay. Strategy is cool. Not having a dredger is not cool. Oh, Rogan can be nice later. I can return it, but no. For a minute, fine. Narset. Narset and Dredge. It's an interesting dynamic. DK. So it's a Sultai. Didn't expect Sultai. Sadly, we have only one green source left, so I want to keep that. Oh, nice. So we'll dredge. Oh, fuck. Fuck me! I milled two mountains, I milled two stomping grounds. What is wrong with this game? Okay, so, okay. Focus. It's not the end of the world. Now we have two lines. Does he have sound? Who? Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 cards. And I didn't draw a card technically because I dredged. So I can just go for rocks. Tmaf Sodek, yes. What I... So I can resolve this. Use fetch land not to find anything. I like this idea. Because, and we'll try to play a game without mana. And I'm going for rocks because I know it will it resolves. Because Force of Negation can counter it. And also it's a 5 power. Okay, we found Amalgam, which is fine. Okay, now some decisions. Do we want to kill Narset or do we want to kill more damage to Dio? Because we can go Bloody Jihir, Narcomoeba to opponent. Not the worst thing to be honest. Because Narset won't be a problem for us, at least as long as we keep Dread Chain ready. And every bit of damage can matter. Obviously they can bounce it and do other stuff, but if I bounce Narset, not my 6 Sanctuary to Cryptic Loops, it's fine for me. Lol, I won. Sure. A nice move to 4. Okay, we are playing versus Sultai, so Bloodborne looks fine. Okay, out at least one chill, if not two. Maybe one Conflag. Maybe. And that's it. We can't loan, which is pretty big. That's true. Like, we couldn't loan because we flipped to Stomping Grounds early. Randomly. And also opponent had... Oh, opponent had some options. To slow us down. Okay, this is... Mull, sadly. Opponent also Mull against. Okay, this is much better. A bit risky, but we have Horn. Conflag maybe to start over. I think it's a keep. We can bottom one Dredgers. Maybe tag. Dumping Sphere? It's not Dumping Sphere. It's Dumping Matrix. What? And if you ask, is it spicy? Yes, it is. Probably Fox is here. Kind of expected. Please discard him. Looks nice. So I go like this, and I want probably will upkeep Merchant to play around both Force of Negation and Ethergust. One power is better than zero here. Some decisions we can cycle. Or keep it. I think cycle is better. We can draw another enabler, we can draw more lands. And later it should be better with loam. Fuck me! Because now there's a real problem with Field of Ruin if it happens. Yes. Okay, so at least we'll be able to conflict discarding Bloody G Imp. So we'll start our Dread Chain. Merchant. Merchant is also interesting. We can just conflict now. Play fetch and go. Looks reasonable. I will return this Bloody G. Like, we won't have many triggers. Because we don't have access to loam yet. Also, I don't want to expose my stomping ground for Field of Ruin. You reckon without treasure is 27? I don't remember, to be honest. Something like this. Close to 50, 30 for sure. Archmage's Charm. Why they don't target me? Okay, but they have 8 life only. We have some power on board, and we have power in form of merchant. We can just drag into stuff. Looks reasonable to me. I'm curious if they want to go for bounce. Okay, this bounce is a sign of weakness. Now we can dredge. Oh, we flipped ox. Ox is nice here. That's interesting. Okay, we can go for. Because we have still four fetchables, so. We shouldn't flip all of them. So we can resolve chill, then go for Ox of Agonas to discard everything and keep my fetch on top to return Bloody G's and attack maybe for lethal. Okay, 3 mountains left. 2 mountains left. Everyone. Okay, that was a wild ride. That last two matches. It was some nice decisions to take. Okay, we can just. To be second, free to dream is fun. Okay, chat. I think this will be enough for me today because I want to write more for my Patreon. So if you want to get access to detailed deck and sideboard guide to Dredge, just check my Patreon. Here. And most likely I will stream tomorrow because like I want to return to my more or less daily early streams. So just stay tuned and I hope we see you tomorrow. Okay, we can just write someone. Good night. Okay, if you are night, if it's night for you, we can do this. See ya. Okay.
Sodek MTG. Thank you very much for the raid, Sodek. Thank you so much. Welcome everybody from Sodek Stream. We are playing Vintage Cube. We're playing with Inger Colossus.